What's up, y'all? It's your girl Janelle again, and I am back with another video. And today I'm just gonna be talking to you all about where I've been, why I've been MIA, why haven't I been doing YouTube videos. Like, sus, what's to me? And yeah, like, I just want to get back on the right path. It's a new year, it's a new start, and it's just like, I just want to be A1 this year, okay? And I just had to get back to reality. And why is it I enjoy doing YouTube, and what is it about it that keeps me going? And it's definitely not because of the money, because sus, I ain't making much of that yet, okay? But what gets me going pretty much really is I enjoy doing it. Like, I really have fun doing videos. It's just I had to get back to enjoying it. Like, I started to look at it more on a business standpoint rather than me just enjoying it and creating content. Like, I was getting so irritated with editing, and I'm like, sus, like, I used to have a ball editing. Like, I used to really enjoy editing my videos, like adding the effects to it and adding a little different slides and stuff like that. Like, I used to really enjoy doing that, and I just started taking it a little too serious and getting too frustrated, which you will have your days when it comes to YouTube. It's just, I had too many. I had too many days. Like, sus, it's time to pull it together. So, yeah, that's pretty much what's been going on with me. But today's video really is not about that. Today's video, I'm going to be telling you all some tips or whatever on how to get 50K more followers on TikTok. Simply because I do have, what, let me check. I have 283,000 followers on TikTok currently. So I feel like I know a little bit on how to get followers or whatever. So that's pretty much what this video is going to be about. I'm going to be telling you all how to gain over 50,000 followers on TikTok fast. Please get your notebooks, your pen, paper, whatever, because these are really good tips. I know for a fact they work, because look at the followers I have now. Go ahead and get your pen and paper out. Get your tea, whatever it is you want to do. And get ready to take these tips, because sis, it's time to elevate for 2022, okay? Oh, before I get started, please do me a favor. Make sure that you subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, feel free to add me on Instagram and all of my other social media platforms. Of course, TikTok. So yeah, go ahead and add me outside of YouTube, so you'll get to mingle with me outside of just YouTube, okay? So anyway, let's just get right into the video. Okay, so tip number one is going to be your lighting and making sure that your camera is clean. When it comes to doing when it comes to doing TikTok, you want to make sure that your lighting and your camera is 100% clean, because lighting makes you stand out. It makes your video look appealing to the eye right then and there. Like, it instantly catches people's attention. If you don't have lighting, I'll insert in the description my lighting. If you don't have lighting, I always say use natural lighting if you can't afford to buy lights and stuff like that right now. Use natural lighting, okay? When you have good lighting in your videos, it makes your videos stand out 100%. Like, I would instantly watch your video if you had good lighting. Like, this look interesting off back, because it looked like they took the time to make sure everything was on point to create this video. They really took their time to create this content. Okay? So yeah, that's the first tip. Tip number two is to find your niche and stick with it. You want to make sure you know exactly what it is you want to do with your TikTok account, because once you start grasping people's attention, that's what they're following you for. Okay? So once you start getting followers, let's say, for example, like for me, I definitely switched my niche on TikTok. First, I was doing like comedy and skits and like fun videos and stuff like that, which is nothing wrong with that. Everybody likes a sense of humor every now and then. I was doing comedy and stuff like that, but then I really realized, I'm like, is this really exactly what I want people to know me for? So I switched over to fashion and clothing hauls and styling tips and stuff like that, and beauty and makeup, simply because that's really what I enjoy to do. I enjoy doing my makeup. I enjoy putting the outfit together and looking cute and taking pictures and stuff like that. So that's the type of content I started to dish out. When it comes to TikTok, you can do whatever it is you really enjoy doing. Like, if you enjoy doing dances, if you enjoy cooking, if you enjoy makeup or hair videos or funny videos, posting about your pets, whatever, posting about your kids, being a mom and stuff like that, or dad or whatever, or being a cute couple, those things, you could be whatever it is you want to be on TikTok. Just make sure you stick with it, because once you start getting those followers, that's what they are watching you for. Now, not saying when you get bigger, you can't switch it up a little bit, because that's exactly what I did. because I wanted to be known simply for my fashion and stuff like that. But whatever you do, in the beginning, you want to stick with it, because you want people to continuously follow you. And once you get those continuous followers, you'll start to see a lot of growth quickly. And it's what they're there to see. They're there to see you for that. Number three, you want to use viral TikTok songs. Now, I'm going to do a quick insert showing you all exactly what I mean and how you can find it. Okay, once you go to your TikTok account, you're going to click on the plus sign at the bottom. So as if you're getting ready to do a video, and you're going to click add sound at the top. Once you do that, there's an option when you scroll down. It says playlist, and it's going to say TikTok viral. You want to click on TikTok viral, and that's going to show you the top trending TikTok viral songs that are trending at this moment. So use those sounds all the time, and it'll really help your algorithm with getting more views and getting more followers and stuff like that. So try your best to do content using those sounds. You can also use your own sounds. Like, some people get famous by using their own sounds or whatever. I say go for it. If you know you're a funny person, or if you know you got some good music or whatever, put it out there, because those videos definitely go viral too. But I'm just letting you know, if you want to get TikTok viral, those are one of the options. Okay, so yeah, make sure you use trending TikTok sound. Yeah, so TikTok has a total of they have a total of 12 top sounds that they do. I believe they change it weekly, of the top trending TikTok sounds or whatever. I don't really know how often they change it, but there's always a change to the music of the songs that's trending. And as you do TikTok, you'll start to get a hang of what's trending and what's not. You'll just start to see, like, okay, this is a popular sound. I keep seeing this on the For You page. Let me go ahead and use the sound. You can always do that too. You can also save sounds and come back to them later and create content using those sounds. Tip number four, you want to use popular hashtags. So I'm going to show you all how to use popular hashtags as well. Okay, so I didn't record anything. I just simply placed my finger over the video just so I could demonstrate how to do it. So once you're at the post where you're ready to put in your description and stuff like that, you want to click on the hashtag button that's underneath. And usually, like right now, it's not showing me any, but usually they'll have trending popular hashtags that's like popular at that moment. You can use pretty much whatever hashtags you want, just make it relate to your video. But these hashtags don't necessarily relate to the videos. They're just trending hashtags at that moment. They're not showing me any right now, but usually there's a hashtag, there will be a thumbs up button next to it, usually showing you what hashtag is popular at that moment. And you will be able to use that hashtag and get more views that way. So usually some people put For You page or trending or FYP, whatever. But those, when you add popular hashtags, it boosts your videos as well. So sorry I couldn't really demonstrate that one, but usually it would show like a thumbs up next to the trending hashtags. It would be a blue thumbs up. So look out for that. It will be on the end of the hashtag. Tip number five, you want to make sure you post consistently. I know a lot of people may have told you that, or that may be something you always hear, but it is very true. I used to upload 6 to 10 videos in a day. Like, I'm not exaggerating. I used to do TikTok so much. Like, I would wake up first thing in the morning and that's the first thing that's on my mind. And I was just doing it because it was so much fun and I was getting so much engagement. Like, I was just, my videos was just going up. And this was before TikTok was paying you or anything. Like, my videos was just going up and I was enjoying that. Like, okay, this is kind of fun. Okay, so yeah, make sure that you post at least 3 to 4 times a day. Simply because you want to get your face out there. You want people to start to see, like, yeah, I do content. I do, I'm here. I'm y'all finna see me. That's what you want, okay? You want to consistently get a chance to be on that For You page. You want to be uploading as much as possible. Now, I know it's a little bit harder if you're going to be doing like cooking videos or like hair tutorials or makeup videos. No, makeup videos you could possibly do more than like a lot of them in a day. I'll explain how. So, for example, with makeup, you could do a transition. You could do this is how I look now. This is how I look once I'm complete. Boom, that's one video. Two, you could do one where you do a full makeup tutorial showing what products that you use. Three, you could do makeup and a get ready with me. Like, you could do a makeup and then put a full fit together. Boom, that's 3 videos. Cooking, you can show them all the products in the beginning. I mean, all the food items in the beginning. And then show them the end result, what it will create. Or you could do a full cooking video showing exactly what it is you use, how you use it, what measurements and this and that. Boom, that's 3 videos. I mean, 2 videos. 3, you can do a cooking at the recipe or have somebody taste it or whatever. Like, it's a couple ways you could get more than one video out there, okay? So those were just a couple examples. When it comes to clothing hauls, I like to do a haul telling you all where the items are from, the links. More than likely, I did a YouTube video to it, and I'm directing you to my YouTube channel to get the all the links and the tags or whatever and the sizes and stuff. And then 2, I would do a transition video. 3, I would create a lookbook, like styling these items, putting them together with different pieces that I already have to create a full look. So yeah, that's already 3 videos. So there's multiple ways that you could get more than one video out there. If you do funny videos, it's so simple. Create multiple funny videos, okay? Tip number 6. I believe I have one more, but this is the final tip. Actually be something you want to watch, okay? Do not just put out anything just to say that, hey, I did some content. Don't be lazy with your content because it shows. It truly shows. When you're tired, if you're too tired, don't do it. Simply because you don't want to put yourself out there as, oh, I'm just doing it because I want to get content out there. Quality over quantity. I always say quality over quantity because you could dish out a lot of videos, but just because you're putting a lot out there doesn't mean it's necessarily watchable. If you want to sit there and enjoy your videos, don't upload it. If you don't feel like that's something you would sit there and be like, oh yeah, I'm about to follow her, don't post it. If you personally don't think it's good enough, do not post it. Because more than likely, you're not the only one who's going to think that. Now, you will have your times where you'll be your biggest critic and you'll just be hard on yourself and stuff like that. So, you'll have to find a way to fight that. But if you genuinely know, like, this is not good enough content, this is not my best, I didn't put my all into this, I look tired, I look like I didn't feel like doing this, don't post it, okay? What I mean by posting something you will want to be, you want to be, like, let's say you like fashion videos and you create a fashion video, but you feel like it's not up to where you want it to be. Not saying that you're going to have the best skills as some famous TikToker already up front, but I'm telling you, you want to make sure that you're trying your best to make it as good as possible. If you don't have the proper lighting, make sure you go by a window, get that good lighting in. If you don't have the best background. Hey, whatever. Go outside, do content. People do it. Find a solid background. Or you can put a sheet up behind you. Make sure it's spread out nice and neat so that people can see, okay, they're trying. Okay, so yeah, you want to make sure that your background and your lighting is up to par, because that really draws people's attention. That's pretty much all the tips that I have for this. I really hope this was beneficial, and I really hope you all succeed with your TikToks account. Feel free to hit me up on Instagram letting me know how you're doing. You can tell me how your content is. Hit me up on my TikTok account. Tell me how your videos are doing so far. Set a one more thing. On TikTok, you can see your analytics of how well your video is doing on your account. So check out your analytics and see how many views you're getting during the week and stuff like that. You could see how many views you got for the week and what day you did better and stuff like that. And whatever day you did good, whatever week you did good, you want to stick to whatever it is you did that week and continue on to do that, and setting better and better for yourself each week, each month, or whatever, however you plan it out. But yeah, you can see your algorithm and stuff like that on your account to help keep task on how well you're doing. Yeah, all I can say is good luck. Put your best foot forward. Try your best to do the best content that you can do. And yeah, once again, go ahead and follow me outside of YouTube. Go ahead and add me on TikTok so you can see what type of content I post personally. And let's win this year, you all. Once again, Happy New Year. You're about to see a lot more of me this year, simply because, for one, sweetheart, I've been planning and I got some content for you all, and I'm just about to get to it, and hopefully you all are about to get to it as well, and let's just have a great year. Bye, loves.